Today I'm gonna be doing some playtesting. First I'm gonna go through my list and start prepping tonight's Steam update. What's up, Farpoke? Hiya. What you doing today, Farpoke? So I'm gonna get my change log open and prep that. Tonight's release, tonight's update to the beta version. Avast! Preparing for school? What school do you go to? Or what kind of school? You talking university school or like high school? Okay, so I'm gonna go through my source tree list. Look at what I've changed since the last release. It's uni. All right. Right on, man. What are you studying? All right, this is a crazy important fix here. Windows didn't run. Engineering physics? Cool. MIT, Murray Institute of Tools. That's a cool name. What was my school's name? Oregon Institute of Technology. The word institute, really, I didn't like that word. But that's only because it really reflected an institute. MIT is a lot different. MIT is prestigious. Even if it is just Murray's Institute of Tools, which is pretty neat. Oh yeah, okay, so fixed. Oh, you sent some emails? Really? Oh, it was a short while ago. Oh, okay. I haven't checked my email yet today. Yeah, I know. But I mean, do you go to a, is your college or university called Murray's Institute of Tools? Or is that just a joke? Evil Awakening segue. University of Maryland. Oh, okay. So where does that come from with Murray, though? Is Murray something, or is this something you just, like, made up just on the spot right then? Oh, yeah, there's a new enemy. Oh, it's a joke you got from your dad? Right on. That's cool. You got a joke passed down to you, and you're passing it along. Sharing it, sharing the joke. Automatically minimizes. Windows version borderless mode stretches to the size of the entire screen. That's a big one. What else on Linux? Something else I fixed on Linux. Oh yeah, just the icon. Yeah. I knew that. What's up, Zanger? Howdy, howdy. Today I'm doing some playtesting. So think about what kind of world seed you want to see. If you got an idea for a world seed, keep it in your mind. I will be asking for it soon. About to start that. Oh, yeah. Fix borderless window displaying a gray. A gray background is all you could see. Hey, Rocky Bunny, what's up? Next debug build. Oh, yeah, I got that working. That doesn't really apply, though. Your engine's 1,000 lines. You wrote a K-lock, man. Nice. Your first K-lock. Oh yeah, this is a cool bug fix. Fixed fire spiders leaving behind a little flame from where they spawned. That actually was a bigger bug than it seemed like. It sounds really tiny when you put it into one line. Scan rays. Oh yeah, this is cool. Scan beam, fire smart. Oh, yeah, level one. Kant's expression, static const. Do you just mean const? Const expression evaluates something. It's kind of nice. It's actually a really great little thing. Maybe some other people can help me with that, answer that question. I'm not exactly quite sure myself how to explain that very well. This one's eh. Yeah, but it's like it's yeah, exactly. Yeah. Thanks, Firepoke. That's a great way to put it. Oh yeah, the alpha blending. This is big too. Alpha blending. Oh yeah, the new story elements. I'm always surprised at what I get done in a week. I'm like, I did all that this week? Good for me. I deserve a pat on the back. What's up, Mr. Frenick? Yep. Nim's alarm. Oh yeah. These are all kind of not really worth mentioning. They're just so tiny. Oh yeah. Fix the blink. Able to light fire pillars. Nice, Mr. Frenick. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm about to do a play test here. So everybody, if you want to call out the world seed, keep a six-letter word in your mind. I'm about to ask for it. So the first person to give me that when I ask for it will be the world seed that we do today. Creating fire. Oh yeah, fire. That's right. This is pretty big too. This is more of a plus 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 thing. Yeah, Rock Bunny. Oh, there goes your word, man. Well, think of another one, man. Think of another one. That's a good word, though. That's a really great word. Galaxy. Gotta remember that one. Oh, that didn't actually work. This whole fix for starting the application. Oh my god, the pre-compiled headers. Those are so great. Oh my god. I've done this like three more times. I've like had to go rebuild on Windows or Linux and been like, yes, it's so much faster. Especially when I'm not streaming because of game show eating the CPU and stuff. fire, ice, poison, lightning, and fear that you create. Basically, you can't be hurt by your own elements, which is pretty big. But you can still be damaged by your own bombs. So there's still that. Oh yeah, Metatron. Metatron can be here by killer bombs. There's some more wave filter. I already mentioned this. Oh yeah, and this is the last one. All right, cool. There. Oh, and also I should check out, I should change all the versions. And then this will be all prepped. We'll have version 095. Okay, change the Windows version. Change the Mac version. Change the iOS version. Change the Linux version. And this is ready, this is prepped. Cool. I love having that done. That's good. Now this is all ready to go. So tonight, when I actually release this update to the beta version, it'll be all ready to go. I can have kind of an easy night tonight. Maybe watch a movie or something. Okay, so what world seed are we doing today, huh? First person to give me a six-letter world seed. That's the world we're gonna do. Potato! Oh, so close. You guys all had it right then. Salad Dongs gets it though. Man, Salad Dongs on it. You were on it. He had that control seed. Salad Dongs had that in his control C buffer ready to go. I'm sure of it. No way, Zyngers gonna say potato too? Hey, wait a minute. What's this whole potato joke? Right? This is like a new meme, right? Everybody's talking about potatoes on Twitter and stuff, and I don't know what's going on. Fill a man in. Tell me what's up with this potato. Yeah, dive down the chat box. Nice, man. Nice, you were prepped. You were so ready. All right, we're doing this. Get my controller just in case I need Oh, is that it? Oh, it's just a euphemism. People have been saying that a lot, though. Like, potato, potato. Okay, let's do this. Convert my save game here, kind of back it up. Oh, I can count to potato? Is that it? I need to look this up. Oh, I still need to watch those old Zelda videos. I got that ready to go on my iPad. Forgot to watch it last night. Potato it is. Oh, should I go permadeath? Yeah, let's do permadeath today. I haven't done permadeath in forever. I hope I don't die. This will be really funny if I die, though. Especially in World Potato. Just Google the image potato. Wow, what happened? What the hell happened? Did it crash? I wasn't even paying attention, and all of a sudden it's just not there. What happened? I can count to potato. What if I told you potato? What the hell? This is funny. Not a good start. Make Songbringer game great again. What the hell happened here? Reference count. Now it's like won't even start. We're in. It's like Sing abort. Sing abort. Abort. Really? You're just aborting? It's not even get air potato. Look, it's not even running. Dude, potato is like the ultimate crash. What happened? This is so curious. I mean, this save data looks okay. Wait a minute, I did plug in my controller. Let's try unplugging that. Not that that would be it. Yeah, that assertion, right? That would... What? But this doesn't really mean anything. It's not showing me what's asserting or failing. It's like it just won't even start Cocos. Okay, this is crazy voodoo. I'm cleaning the build. Watch, I'm gonna rebuild and it's not gonna help. Line 90 on that file, that was ccref.cpp, right? I suppose we can. I'm pretty sure this is just a reference counter, though. Mate, Cocos 2DX, Cocos base CC ref. Super voodoo, man. Okay, it's releasing something that never even got a reference count. Okay, so what was it releasing? It was in games destructor. What in here could possibly be released? Well, probably something up here with one of these. I don't know. I'm hoping that just fixed it. Shared pointers are the bane of your existence at work. Oh, man. What the hell? Wait a minute. I did do permadeath. Hold on. It might be permadeath mode. Let me turn off that. Actually, here. Let's go like this. Mode regular. No? What the hell? Is it potato? This is so crazy. Here, let's turn, well, yeah, let's turn off this completely. This is so crazy. I've never experienced something like this before in my entire development of this game. Okay, so it runs. It runs if I don't do this. What about Mega Seed Potato? Is it just the potato seed? Oh my God, it's the potato seed! It totally is! Potato! How great is this? How great is this, huh? I get to figure out why the word potato completely breaks the game. I'm just confirming it. I'm running it again. Oh my God! Oh my God, this is so funny. Right? Are you guys witnessing this with me? This is so great. The word potato just completely borks the whole game. Oh my God. What do we do? What do we do? Do we go with potato or with another six-letter word? It's a feature. It's potato crashes it. It's a feature. Yeah, second place seed. Second place seed, what was it? What was the second place? Too much starch. Wait, what did you guys shout out? Potato, fuzzy. Fuzzy. All right, we're doing fuzzy. Ah. There we go. Got into somebody else's chat. Galaxy was a close third. Fuzzy, well, yeah, fuzzy will work. Can that be a C++ 20 standard? Too much starch. Holy crap. This is so weird. All right. Well, I already got a bug noted for today's. I'm not sure if I'm actually gonna fix that today, but maybe I will. Potato. Potato. All I have to write here is potato, dude. I know what that means. This is like really high on my bug list right here. Potato. How ridiculous. It like crashed the game before the game even had a chance to start, too. Such an amazing bug. All right, let's try this again. We're gonna do word world seed fuzzy and hope that fuzzy is a lot fuzzier than a potato. Yeah, I did ask for six letters, but we'll take it. It's all good, man. Still gonna do permadeath. Hopefully I don't die. It would be amazingly funny if I do die, though. So the way this works, if you don't fill in all letters, it takes your world seed, generates random numbers based on whatever letters you've already given it, and then deterministically fills in the last letters. So fuzzy will always end the same way, no matter what. So if you enter the word fuzzy, it's going to be the same on every platform, basically. But behind the scenes, it really is six letters. Why did I make it? I'll remember that, man. I guarantee. That's what you say when you look at your boards. Why the hell did I write that? Oh. I usually do that when I look at comments I wrote like 6 months ago or something like that. Why did I write this in a comment? This is the worst comment ever. This isn't helpful. This isn't even close to helpful. Hope I have enough time in this game to do a couple alternate, or maybe like one alternate intro. Be nice to have an alternate intro. Just like kind of either randomly plays, or maybe it plays after you've already beat the game or something. Like kind of along the same lines, but maybe just different graphics. You have a git commit with just dot. Nice. It's, yeah, it could be with the world gen. It takes the world seed potato and it's just breaking somewhere so bad that it just, I don't know, is it a serp failing? It could just be crashing. It could just be like seriously just like buffer overflow or something. All right, fuzzy works. Yay. Potato. I miss World Seed Potato. I wonder what Potato looked like. I still need to put some kind of secret in the bike. Oh, is the game volume not there? You guys can't hear it? Is it just low? Game show. La la la. It looks like you got sound. Is it just really low? Oh, is it at 10? No, it's at 5. Yeah. Yeah, I got my audio at 5. And my video at 30, so we're good. Nice, right? Mutinous. Mutinous is a cool name. Oh, it stops your counter during this. I didn't notice. What do you guys think? Should it stop the counter during cutscenes like that? Mode has the timer. We're in permadeath mode. If I die, I am dead. And this whole playtest will have been for naught. So just run into this guy. Doing really good against this guy so far. Already lost half my health. Yeah! It doesn't stop the world tick, it just stops the game time, yeah. So it basically doesn't count against your overall time for the game. I suppose I have to check this secret. Make sure it still works. Yeah. Yeah, the laser effect's pretty good, right? I'm liking it too. Actually, I kind of want to hear these sounds. Okay, cool. It's just a basic thing. Shows me that the area completion is still working. So the game timer's running there. Yeah, exactly, yeah. Let me note that, actually. So, let game time run during cutscenes. All right, let's explore this. Which way? Left, up, down, right? Feel free to call out and I'll change direction. I'm going left for now. What's up, rock face? This guy's got some new horns on his shoulders. He's a little bit harder. He's a little bit smarter. He throws the horn thing a lot more. He was kind of weak before. He still is kind of weak. But since you're running around the overworld, you might have no health. You might have plenty of health. I want him to be not too hard. Having the timer up there, it's pretty nice. Just getting oh hey, what's up, dude? You're just chilling here at the end of this Cul-de-sac? I gotta make this dialogue a little better. I wanna do a nice story element for him. So when you first come up on Brutus, he's like trying to catch a rabbit or a deer or something like that. Cause he's a hunter. And you scare away the deer, and that's why he's so pissed off. That's why he's so mad. Okay, we're totally the wrong way. To get to level one at least. Okay. Combo, I'm cheating. This is a playtest here. I do have to cover some ground. Oh, you know what? There's probably a secret here. But I don't got time to find it! It's fun to be in God mode. Maybe God mode should be an item that you eventually get. What do we got here? What is this? What's in here? Ooh, proton shield. And the biodetector. I would buy the biodetector if I had the money. They're great if you're doing a playtest. But if you want to just be lost, don't get the biodetector. Aw, man. So, that wasn't the way to go? Maybe this is? That's a tricky little way to go. So the timer doesn't really matter. I'm in God mode. What does matter is that if I die, the save will delete itself. Yeah, there's time of day. And there's different stuff that happens at night. I'm invincible. There's no way I can die in this tiny, easy dungeon. Oh, see, here's one of these new drop guys. Oh, there's two of these new drop guys. There's three of these new drop guys in this room. This is a difficult room. These guys should not be in such difficult. Hold on. Fix that right now. Drop two, where it has like a bunch of them. Here we go. Drop this one. This should be like difficulty 0.5 to 1. These are hard. A room full of only these guys should not be like one of the first rooms you encounter in dungeon 1. Definitely not. This will keep it so that they only appear if they're in more difficult rooms. Okay, but let's continue with these guys. God damn! I can't just kill the world seed, I'm cheap. This way. Cheating's fun. Yeah, cheating's good. Gotta make it as fast as I can, cause I've got a lot of ground to cover. Already wasted a lot of time with the potato. I zoom in on nothing there. That bug where this skeleton falls over twice, gotta fix that. Oh hey, here's this room. This is new, this is a difficult room. Oh my god, I died! That was permadeath mode. Oh man. So wait a minute, if I quit the game right now, I think it might not save. Try it. today's playtest has been hilarious. Oh, it worked. Galaxy will be next. If necessary, Galaxy is waiting in the wings. Okay, so this room right here, this new room I just created or whatever with a bunch of guys in one room, this is super difficult. Especially if you don't have bombs. Nice, right on. Thanks, Mr. Frenick. Oh, because there's two of these guys. That room is too difficult. For level one, at least. So, I'm gonna add something here to foes so that stairs two. We'll just call this one do we already have a stairs two pattern? Yeah, we do. No, that's for, if I had clicked continue, it would have saved and destroyed my save game right then. So this is kind of a cheat or a workaround or something that you can kind of like, if you know as a player, that if you quit the game, if you hard quit the game, basically, not like using the interface, but if you just like force quit the game before you click continue, it will not erase your permadeath save game. So I kind of like that. It's kind of a feature almost. It's a hidden secret feature. What do you guys think? Weigh in on that. Should the game actually forcibly delete your save game as soon as you die before you even have a chance to force quit the game? So that's pattern stairs two. And if it's Z, like one through four, even put no enemies there. You're probably more ruthless. Huh. We got two opinions. I'm in the leave it how it is camp. But should we do one of those let's do that. It's a thing called straw poll. Straw poll. Should Songbringer erase your permadeath save game if you force quit? Yes. Yes. Ruthless. No. Keep this hidden feature. Creeple. What if it took two autosaves? You mean like if you try and force quit, it takes away two of your games? Or the game addresses the player? Huh. Okay, third time going through this dungeon here. In permadeath mode. So there shouldn't be any foes now in this room down here. Good. No foes here. At least the dungeons 1 through 4. The higher dungeons can definitely have foes there. It's just that that's such a tight room. It's really difficult. It's not very dungeon 1 friendly. I guess I could make that restriction a little bit more. Like, instead of it being 1 through 4, it could be like 1 through 3. Only like the first two dungeons you're gonna encounter. Because one of those is the swordless, you're never gonna get that. Enjoy your leisure time, and if people want to spend it like that, even if in self-denial or whatever, then there's... Yeah, where's the harm, right? Yeah, you're right. Single player. It's kind of a nice feature, right? Let's see what other people think, though. Vote for the poll! What do you think? Should the game be ruthless? Should this hidden feature stay as it is? Yeah, right? Self-aware. You're trying to force quit. Yeah, I guess that is a really great thing about Undertale, isn't it? It sort of causes you to question everything about video games playing Undertale. We have here another key. I swear I just picked up both of these and I didn't gain any health from that. Am I going crazy? Hold on. I need to test that. That's pretty important. What the hell just happened there? If I have an initial hurt of 2. Invincible off. See that? Courage didn't go up. What if I get hurt though? Yeah, dude, what is going on here? Oh. Can't heal in permanent mode. I think I know what it is. It's this, this new code I added for the is same team. Wow, this is so big. This is such a big ass bug. This has to do with the, I think what's going on is that. That you were ruthless. Okay, yep, it's doing that. Same team, what are you talking about? Same team. What does the changer have? Changer collision flat collision category. Just 32. What's that? That's one shifted up 5, 4, 0. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What category is that? 5 is friend for real? Who put friend on the health in the thingies? I think that's from the emit item function. I think so. Let's see if that happens when I open up one of those chests. Is this emit item thing. It shouldn't be giving it the category friend. It should be neutral or nothing. Emit items, why is this happening right away? Bombable pillar? Oh. Okay. The item. Switch 4-7. No, it's life. Okay. Life. Good. He's small. Do item status. Velocity and stuff. Create item. Here we go. Is it adding any flags afterwards? No. Okay, it must be in this create item function then. It's K filter item. K filter not. Wait a minute. What's K filter item? Item's 9. Why would it? Why would it not have had K filter 9 or number 9 on there? Wait, 9. That's one shifted up 9. As a move component. Oh, it has a cooldown. Yeah, none of this None of this adds K-filter friend. Okay, something weird's happening. Or I'm just not understanding. And to be more pragmatic, this should be entity get collision component. Id collision or else collision or else return. The player getting Okay, the player already picked up the item. Okay, gosh, I didn't need to go through that whole little debugging process there at all if I had just looked at my call stack. So the player picked up the item and then calls change HP from within pickup item using its own ID. Which it should never do. It should never just. Yeah, the right thing to do here is to pass in 0 for the changer. Okay, so what I'm gonna do to try and see if I made that mistake anywhere else in the code is to look for all instances of change HP and see how many of these are referencing themselves. There's target 0, EID 0, ID 0, 0, 0. Wait, this one might be EID, E.ID. Oh, EID is the list of entities. It's damaging. Okay, that one's okay. Explosive damage, same thing. It's looping over a list, applying it, using a changer, EID. Collision system 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Here's another one. EID changer. Could changer at all ever be EID in this? What is this? Freeze. Potentially. But that's only if, because freeze only happens being called from change HP. So, get my player 0000. There's other ID and EID. Okay, all these look good. Wait, what's other ID here? This is push others. Oh, this is where something is pushing other stuff. Oh, this is where it kills the player if the wall pushes you all the way into something else. Okay. So to finish that off, inside change HP, I can assert. So in debug mode, I can catch this if I ever am accidentally doing this. Assert EID's not equal to changer EID. So if id, actually if id's zero, let's just bail out there. So there, id's definitely something. And if id, it's just that we're asserting that id is different than the changer id. Okay, there we go. You found out they were offering a class on game design? Nice, man. You're implementing Valtry? Stir2L? What do you need for Ming? Stir2L. Standard IO, standard lab. Just standard lab. I thought Valtry already had standard lab. It does. I don't know why you're getting that. Do you have this line? Do you have include standard lab? Let's see what the Linux version says. Is it different on Linux? No, it's also standard lab on Linux. Is your Ming compiler different? Huh. I don't know, man. It should be all right. Try it. Yeah, see if that works. There we go. That's a lot less ruthless. I'm gonna jump on you, man. This item, like, looked like it randomly appeared. It did. That's kind of a bug. Okay, how we doing this straw poll, huh? Results. Ruthless! We got 4 votes for ruthless! Y'all are some ruthless people! Wow, so you prefer. Okay. Okay. That kind of is more real, right? I feel you. I feel you. Right? Because you don't want to. Just. If you have the ability to cheat, you know, you're probably going to. If you know there's. That you can cheat, makes you a lot more likely that you will. Hmm. Sub-Zero. Oh, thank you for guiding me so quickly. He's so slow, you can catch up with him. Something. Can't buy the proton shield yet? Gypped. Feel not gypped, but I feel gypped. Rocket Bunny didn't work, man. Whoa, 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 whoa. Is this really a yo, you can't get past here. Oh. Area 1010. World Seed Fuzzy. Huh, Ragabine, this reminds me of your problems you were having the other day with printf. Oh, can't get through there. Gotta fix this bug. This new thing where you can walk. Oh, there, it got through. Nice. Wow. Okay, I'll fix that. What's up, dude? Hey! That reminds me, might as well use these. You had some bugs, what were they? Cool, glad this worked. And Brutus should be still here. Good. If I go back to where Brutus was, which I think was it here? Yeah, it was like here. Yeah, he's gone. Okay, he's definitely gone. Cool. Oh, he was right here. That's right. Was he? Yeah. Okay, good. What's up, Zero? What are you doing? Walking into a cave? Who are you, this mysterious guy? Okay, so there's a bug. There was a bug. If you get that, get this, get a story. Oh, it didn't work. Oh, it did work. Story element still played. Good. Whoops! I had full health and let me use that. That's not supposed to let you use it when you. Maybe I didn't quite have full health. Hey man, what's going on? This person crashed two dialogues in places where there was nothing there. There was no bike crash? Oh man, I would need to know what area and what world seed. I would at least need to know what world seed and approximately where you were. Because what might have happened is it might have tried to put a bike crash pattern, but it didn't quite put the bike crash tile. But the game thought that there was still a bike crash there, and so it did the bike crash dialogue. Okay. Well, man, I'm really glad I fixed that bug with not being able to ever heal. From getting the small demon's tooth, that was a big bug. No, stir too well, it definitely works. I'm using C++ 14. And it definitely works in GCC, Microsoft Visual Studio, and Xcode, because I'm using all those compilers. I think it's a meme problem, man. You already had one meme problem this week. Rocket Bunny, can you do this? Can you go to this website? Here, I'll give you this link. Just go do this little example program. See if this compiles with Ming. Oh, you can't get the last pillar? Oh no, that's just you gotta there's a puzzle to that. Yeah, you can get that. Oh, and then the only wait, the only way to get through it is going by through this. Oh, okay, you may, oh, I get it. Okay, so what world seed is that? All I need in that one is the world seed, and then I can go to that dungeon and see what you mean. Because I do, yeah, I believe you totally, because that could totally happen where you could. Yeah, see the example program doesn't work. I think that's a problem with Ming. It's Jerry. Okay. Jerry cannot get last swordless two puzzle because toggle isn't accessible. There should be two toggles though. Oh, you check for secret paths? Yeah, okay. So you sound like you're pretty thorough about it. So maybe for some reason it didn't put the second toggle somewhere, or it didn't put the second toggle accessible. So thank you. I will get that one fixed. Yeah, Clang does run on Windows. I think you can get it with Microsoft Visual Studio even. Somebody else know that? Farpoke, you still here? Do you know about Clang on Windows? You can definitely get Clang on Windows. I know people are doing it. You can also get GCC on Windows. Oh, you haven't tested? Only Linux? Oh, yeah. I love this dialogue. Light stuff on fire! Yeah, yeah, yeah! Causes conflicts with everything else? Really? What kind of conflicts have you found? Runtime library conflicts. You mean on Linux? Oh my god, yeah, that could be hell on Linux for sure. Like, does it do like a different libc or something? Sir 2LL. You definitely learned something from doing that. But it does concern me for your future projects and stuff that you would have a problem with such a basic thing. I can't wait to make that soundtrack procedural. That ought to be pretty fun once it's like has a different melody each time. You could. That would be pretty sweet. Really? Is that how he does it? He does no libraries whatsoever? Libraries, not even like no standard libraries, like no math functions, no string, no vector. That's just masochistic. I respect that. That's so cool. If I had like infinite time, I would do something like that too, because it does sound fun. Just write all your own, write your own string class, write your own, like, everything. That's fine. Don't know if that's a bug or not. Oh, that thing, when you push it, it does this extra little push at the end because of the friction. Or because of the lack of friction in this dungeon. How to do it, yeah. But I bet it's also fun for him. Done in a long time is used a biodetector inside a dungeon. I should do that right now. It's been far too long. Okay, there, it's revealing that the boss is way down there. Wow. Or no, that could be the switch. Oh, it should be the switch actually. Yeah, it shows you where the switch is first, I think. Yeah, that's cool. I bet it would really speed up your compilation, not having to rely on other stuff, writing your own classes. Saladong's doing a lot of that. He's got his own memory management even in his game engine he's writing. You implemented half a kernel? No way. In assembly? Man, these guys are hard to kill. Health. Do you want to write your own scripting language too? Is it in your own OS? Cheating. Back here, you coward. Whoa, oh hey, thanks for showing me a secret. Oh, I was like trying to hurt him and I was in invincibility mode. So was he. But I did find that biodetector, sweet. You like bare bones assembly? You like that stuff? I consider that to be masochistic right there. I'm not exactly an assembly master. That stuff freaks me out. I'm like, wait a minute, I gotta push to AX. What? What do I do after I push to AX? That's true. Yeah, writing your own compiler? Oh, I don't got my ghost sword yet. Where is the ghost sword? Don't freak out, because these guys are hard. Ah, oh, run away! This playthrough has been already quite fruitful. Found a few important bugs. Got them fixed already. adjusted a few things too with the new little rooms and other little things there in this version. It's been an important thing. Important to do playtests when you're releasing so often. It's kind of a lot. It's kind of a lot to release once a week. You know, like a good half day every week is like spent on polish, which is probably why the game is how it is. Gotta finish your homework. All right, man. See you, Farpub. Happy homeworking. Oh, already got the ghost sword. So hopefully this biodetector points to the boss room after this. It should. Whoops. Oh well. Yes, it does. Cool. I'm glad the biodetectors still work inside the dungeons. I haven't really tried that in months. It's good to know you code your road. It's still working. Single sprite in the game can have, well, if an entity has a reflection component, then it takes whatever sprite it has as its render component. So there's render components, shadow components, reflection components. The render component has a sprite. In this case right here for the main hero, Rock, it's just his current sprite, right? And then the reflection component, every single time the render engine or the render system goes and ticks through all the render components, it updates the reflection component to have the same sprite, right? So it's just a sprite that's flipped over, made a little bit transparent, and then it uses a special shader which uses a mask. So there's a mask for everything that is supposed to be reflective, and it just the shader just uses that mask too. to make sure that everything that the reflection components draw is in the right. That's why when you go over here and I go off like that, it's not showing the reflection component on the rest of the ground. It only shows it on the ground that's supposed to be reflective. Yeah. This shouldn't be. That shouldn't be a story element for what? This should be a comment. Okay. Oh, it's right there. Oh, you're updating Bing? All right, cool, bunny. Does. Rock face. Face still works. Oh, here's the. That's also a tricky level to find. I love Prog Gen games. Didn't work? Oh. Hey. Have you tried GCC yet? G++? Oh, GCC has the same error? Sounds like it's like the Dude, does GCC and Ming, do they share the same libraries? Sounds like a library error more than a compiler error. Like, how do you install libraries on Windows? I've never used GCC or Ming on Windows. So how did you go about installing your libraries and all that? Or did it just come with Ming? Like did Ming, when you installed Ming, did it like install C standard libraries and stuff? Yeah, I'm sure it is. Sure does sound like it. Gets so scary. Need more bombs, man. Bombs. Yeah, it's so nice to have a batch file, right? To compile with Microsoft. With MSVD. BCC. BC. This is only dungeon 4. How much you bet there's a secret up here? Oh, there's not. No secret. Wah, wah. Ah! Panic! Mayhem! Oh, This dungeon has a really sprawling layout. Yeah. Batch file, totally. So nice. You can even use CMake. CMake is compatible with Visual Studio. We've got the boots now. That's something I've been meaning to do, is set up everything so I can CMake on any platform. But I just haven't yet. Get some more of these scanner drones. Use those. I don't know where the next dungeon is! What to do? Oh, let's go to Songbringer. Oh, but I don't have anything to craft. Exploring a little bit. You go. Oh, it looks like this whole world is blocked off. Except if I go that way to the top. Wow. This is a funny world. This week, though, that was so beneficial was finally setting up pre-compiled headers on Linux and Windows. I just hadn't done that ever because I always compile on Mac. And the only time I ever compile for Linux and Windows is once a week when I do a release or do a beta update. So I finally did that, and oh my god, the Windows build is like 4,000% faster. I think I did that yesterday. Ridiculous. It went from 10.5 minutes down to 2.5 minutes. It really surprised me how much faster it was. Yeah, I think that was yesterday, so. Yeah. Crazy. And then later on that night, I got some things working on Linux. That was pretty fulfilling. I was like, yes, finally Linux. I got this icon working on Ubuntu. All I had to do was chmod 755, the desktop file. A really simple thing, but something you don't really know. And why, you know, why does it work on this window environment, but not Ubuntu? That's the situation I was in. It's like, why doesn't it work? But it does now. I like this world. This world's pretty neat. I think I'll keep it. But I would like to find another dungeon, please. Thank you. What's this? Oh, that's gonna be a story element. Where are we at? What is this? I like this world. Oh, here we go. Here's something. You know you're would you watching at work tomorrow? Nice, man. What do you do for work? If you don't mind me asking. If you do mind me asking, just ignore my question. Oops. Sorry, man. I didn't mean to kill you that easily. Need to fight these more important rooms and stuff. Still doable. Make sure there's no problems with the new. Sweet, you're an engine programmer? Wow, that sounds fun. Right on. You guys working on a certain game right now? Is it, if it's a secret, you don't need to tell me. Oh no! Now we got something to craft. I think this is a pretty good hint. You got this new tile you've never seen before. You got acid. You should have the teleporter by now. Oh, cool. Writing a lot of previous engine. Nerd Kingdom? Cool. Doug. Whoa, sweetheart. Got some pro artists. Oh, it's three. Cool. Awesome. Access? Right on, man. Oh, that's the old build, huh? Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. You prefer 2D games too? Nice. I like 2D games myself. Poison Blink, maybe? I don't think I've done the Poison Blink. Nice, man. To my satisfaction. Oh, thanks, man. That's a compliment. Don't worry, I just barely started out on my own. Just a couple years ago with this project. Before that, I always believed I had to work in teams. Like I was like, ah, I'm not talented enough to do my own art. I'm not talented enough to do my own music. I never really fully believed that in myself. And then one day I was just like, maybe I can make art. So I just started making it. And at first I felt like I sucked. If you look at some of my first streams, they really weren't that great at Bard. But, you know, you get better at everything. What's this? Found it! Yeah, exactly, right? You never know what you can do until you try. It's funny how your beliefs can completely stop you from, you know, doing what could be the most fulfilling thing you've ever done, you know? So far, Songbringer has been the most fulfilling thing I've ever done creatively. And it's like, I don't know, it's helped me get rid of so much angst I had for so many years. I was like, I had this feeling that I wanted to make my own games. I wanted to make games how I wanted to make them. And I was always in teams of people where, you know, you have to compromise on what you want to do in a video game because other people want to do something else. So, I don't know, I just never wanted to compromise on that, and oh man, it's just so fulfilling to be able to do whatever the hell you want. Great feeling. Ugh. And had I stayed with my old beliefs, if I had kept on believing no, I can't do art, I never would have done this. This game would not be here being made. That would be a sad thing. Your ideal is to work by yourself entirely? Or with just one or two people? Yeah? Yeah, large teams can be. I know what you mean. Yeah. I worked in a couple large teams. Recently. Bombs definitely help. Do a lot of damage. Almost dead. No dying! No dying allowed. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Mr. Frank. It's been a lot of work. A lot of love. I don't really consider it work. I guess I say work just to try and get some, I don't know, empathy? I don't know why I do that. Yeah, I love what I do. I don't consider any of it work. Well, some of it I do. Some of it, like, you know. Like if I had to work on Android, that would be work. Android's tough sometimes. Not that it's a bad OS or anything, I'm just saying it's a tough OS to support because of all the problems you have. All the devices. You know what? There should be secrets coming off the boss rooms. That'd be so cool if there was a secret somewhere. One of these. Shield. We got a shield now. Nice. Yes, needing multiple items from other dungeons, totally Mutinous. Yeah. So I've mentioned this a few times, but the next month, like December and January, those months are going to be dedicated to going back through the dungeons and making them more interesting. Refining the art, making the bosses better, making sure there's more enemies, more variety, that kind of stuff. So that, I will definitely be working on that. Like, making it so you, the gate items, yes, with secret fights, for sure. I want to have secret bosses too, like optional bosses or mini bosses or something like that. Okay, so there's a key at the end of this tunnel. You know, there's probably a secret around here somewhere. Yeah, there's co-op. Yeah, you can play two players. The second player plays as Jib or Bell. Oh, check it out. There's two secrets here. Which way do I go? Yeah, and there's going to be a lot of challenges to the game, too. So you can play with only the top hat, for example. That's a pretty interesting challenge. Oh, nice. Only any of the weapons. If you want to just get the blink or just get the, you know, not get the sword. But then another one of the challenges will be to get Vel really, really early on in the game. And the game is designed so that you can get Vel. Vel is like, basically she's required to get into the tower, the last dungeon. So she's kind of, in the normal run of this game, you'll end up getting Vel really late in the game. But there's a way you can get her, like, basically before you even go and finish even the first dungeon. So that'll be a pretty interesting challenge to do, like, reverse boss order. And in reverse boss order, the second player will always be Vel for the whole game. So that should be pretty interesting, too. There should be a lot of replayability to this game. If there's not, I definitely have designed this game wrong. Because the procedural element gives it a lot of replayability. Just want to maximize that, you know? Make it really fun. to play. Really surprising. That's my biggest pet peeve in video games today, is games where I didn't even get the second level blanket I got in this room. Oh, I need to gate this room. I'm so stuck down here. And I'm in permadeath mode. This is not a good combo. Hold on. I'm saving and quitting. It saved and quit me right there, and I love only one tooth. That wouldn't happen in release mode. In release mode, it would have put me back at the beginning. Oh, no, I haven't really thought about that. Like items that would go across the game, sort of like you acquire this item in a certain run so that you can kind of have it for next run. Is that what you're talking about? Oh, here's where it was. Okay, so that's already on my list to fix that. So, outside that boss room right there, there should be some sky tiles, or some pits, basically, so that you can't get into that room until you've gotten the second level of the blink, which allows you to blink over, like, one tile's worth of a gap. Huh. So, that, yeah, that's an idea. That could work. Whoa. Where am I? Oh. This room was locked, and I got into a secret. Oh, bombs! Very cool. That's a nice secret. You play roguelikes? One thing that has replayabilities that have meta unlocks. Yeah! I like it. Yeah, maybe it wouldn't count towards your overall. Ooh, nice, circuit breaker. Just got all the important items right there. Yeah, that's a really good point. That definitely does add to replayability, doesn't it? Oh, check it. Both those were bombs. Oh, but nothing here. Secret path there, though. There's secret paths all over this dungeon. We haven't even seen all of it. Yeah, what could be that meta item? Oh, what I was saying was I don't think it should affect your overall score. So like you can still get 100% at the end of the game without getting that meta item or meta items or whatever they are. Any help. Jib doing? Heal with. Oh, gotta kill her in the next moves or nothing. Oh, no, 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 dude. Oh, good thing the cheat's still in here. The cheat. Huh, well, I'm pretty sure the game's all right. I played a lot of it right there. I think that's going to be it for today's stream. I got to sit down, get some dinner or something. So, yeah, I'll keep working tonight. I'll try and fix that potato bug. That was so funny. Yeah, so thanks a lot for watching, everybody. And as always, thanks for your support. And, yeah, check y'all next time. Probably be back tomorrow. Maybe I'll take tomorrow off. I don't know. We'll see. So, yep. Have a good one, everybody.